Hi everyone, I'm Ellie from Code of the Future, and today we're going to be exploring a little mini quiz that you can be getting stuck into to test your Python knowledge. So we are reaching the end of this tutorial series that I've been running, and it's been absolutely incredible the feedback I've got from everyone, how many people have liked and subscribed and watched my videos. It's been absolutely phenomenal, so I just want to say thank you to everyone who has followed me on this journey with this channel. I have huge things planned for this channel, so I'm really grateful that all of you out there have helped kickstart it. If you have any suggestions for other videos, then do comment them down below. I just want to release content that people will enjoy and people will watch. So we are on the penultimate video. Across this whole tutorial series, we've covered a whole range of different things. So to finish off this tutorial series, I thought I'd switch up and actually release my own mini quiz that you can use to test yourself on how, you know, how great your Python knowledge is at the moment and maybe where some weaknesses lie. So the way this video is going to work is I'm going to first start by talking you through 8 problems, and the idea is that you'll listen to me, listen to all the problems, hopefully go away and try them yourselves, and then once I've finished explaining the 8 problems and what they are, then I will be showing you the answers and just explaining how I got to the answers and how the answers work. And don't forget, with Python as well, there are so many different ways of doing things in Python that even though your answer may not look the same as mine, it will still work. But the idea is that if you can get to an answer yourself, then that means you've worked hard and you've given it a good go. So you can pause the video when I ask the questions and then fast forward. I will put all timestamps in the description box to where the questions answers are, so you can do a question, go see what the answer is, then go back and do a question, and hopefully you'll have learned quite a lot through this tutorial series. So I'm going to get started straight away and give you the problems. So the first question is on assigning variables. So can you create 2 variables, both x and y, that are assigned to any number that you want? So x and y can be any number that you want. And can you find the sum of those 2 variables, the division, the subtraction, and the multiplication of those 2 variables? So question number 2 is on lists. So can you create a list from 0 to 100 that only has the even numbers in it? So that would be a list of 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, all the way up to 100 with no odd numbers, all even numbers. And then once you've created that list, can you get Python to print the first 10 elements in that list? And can you also find the length of the list in Python? Now to finish off, can you append a value, any value you want, to this list, print it, and see if Python has indeed appended the value? And with this appended value, it can be any type, so a Boolean, an integer, a float, anything. Okay, question number 3. Can you assign a variable again to any integer you want? And can you, using an if statement, find whether this number that you've assigned is divisible by 5, and can you get Python to print whether it is or it isn't? Question number 4. Using a for loop, can you get Python to print the numbers 0 to 5? Question number 5. In Turtle, can you draw a pentagon? Question number 6. Can you create a function that tests whether 3 numbers are a Pythagorean triple? So 3 numbers, A, B and C, are considered a Pythagorean triple if A squared plus B squared equals C squared. Question number 7. This is incorporating the while loop, but can you spot the error in the code that is coming up on the screen now? Now finally, question number 8. Can you create 2 lists of length 5 and plot these against each other using matplotlib? So those are the 8 questions. I'm now going to show you the answers on my screen. I'm going to talk you through why the answers are the way that they are. Okay, so we are in Python, and these are all the answers to the questions, and I'm just going to talk you through them one by one. So question 1 was creating 2 variables and then asking them to print the multiplication, the addition, the subtraction, and the division. So here we have assigned an x variable equal to 10. So perfect, that's how we assign variables. And we're just going to copy that and pop it into here. And we're going to say we've assigned a y variable now, and we've equal, and we've made it equal to 3. Now this here, if you remember, the asterisk is multiplication. So this is the multiplication. This here, very simply, is the addition. This here is the subtraction. And if you remember what division was, this here is a division. So very nice. That's a really nice starting question, just to incorporate a little bit of maths and a little bit about assigning variables. So that is how you should have answered question 1. But don't forget, there are other ways of producing the same result. Okay. So if we were to run this Python file, then we would get exactly what is in these print statements. Perfect, that's question 1 done. Now, question 2, which is here. So we were asked to create a list from 0 to 100 that was only the even numbers. Okay, so we could incorporate the modulus sign and test whether every single value is divisible by 2. So we know that the even numbers are 2, 4, 6, 8, all the way up to 100. So what we can simply do is we can create a list using this command here, and we can have it in the range starting from 0 to 100 that goes up each time by 2. So what's worth noting is here, if this was 1, then it would be the odd numbers. So this will produce the list of even numbers because it will start with 0, go up by 2, which is 2, and then go up by 2 each time. So 2, 4, 6, 8, all the way up to 100. And remember, we need 101 in here because Python goes to this number minus 1, which is 100. That is how we create the list. Perfect. Then this here will print the first 10 elements in this list. So we are asking Python to take my list and print the first element all the way up to the 10th element. So that's how we print the first 10 elements in a list. And similarly here we have the length of the list. Now this is something that you will probably remember. It's one of the first things I picked up straight away. That was how you find the length of a list, is simply saying print the length of my list. And then here we have appended a value to the list. So we have said take my list, which is defined here, and we're going to append true. So I have chosen a Boolean. You could have easily said this number here, or you could say hello. You know, you could assign anything to this list. And then if we print my list, it will show you the list with that appended on. Perfect. So that's question 2. Question 3 was incorporating an if statement to find whether a number is divisible by 5 or not. So I chose this incredibly crazy number. You know, you could make it even bigger than that. You could make it something crazy like that. Okay, so what we do is we assign number to equal any number of your choice. We say if this specific number divided by 5 leaves the remainder 0, then we know it is divisible by 5. Perfect. Now we've done this in one of the previous videos, so if you've watched that video, then this will be a breeze to you. We've done it, we did it with divisible by 2. And then what we say is if this isn't true, we'll say else. So that means if that isn't true, then finally we'll do these things. A is not divisible by 5. And I've just noticed I originally assigned this value to A, which is why we have A in here. So sorry, that's a slight mistake on my part. I originally assigned it as A, but then I assigned an A further down. So I just need to correct that to number there. So number is not divisible by 5. Okay, if we print this Python file, it will tell you exactly whether that number is divisible by 5 or not. Okay, question 4, incredibly easy. We want Python to print the numbers from 0 to 5 using a for loop. So what we say is for I in range 6, print I. Okay, and what this will do is it will say for I in the range from 0, and remember it's up to 5 because range works by taking the final value minus 1. So if we run this, it will print 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Perfect. Okay. So that's question 4. Now question 5 was incorporating turtle. So there is a little squiggle underneath here, and that is because PyCharm likes you to keep all your imported modules at the top of the Python file so things don't get confused later on. So that's why we have two little errors up here. They are simply because two modules aren't at the top. So what we say is for the turtle, we'll import turtle because that's what we need for it to draw anything in turtle. We'll say for I in range 5, so we know a pentagon has 5 sides. So we're just going to put here, a pentagon has 5 sides, so that's why we choose 5. Now here we are turning right, we could turn left, we could have gone either way, but we're turning right 72 degrees. So 72 times 5 is 360, which is how many degrees there are in a circle. So basically the angle between each side in a pentagon is 72 degrees, which is why we've put 72 here. So we'll say this is the angle needed to produce a pentagon. Okay, and then here we could take 100, you could take 200, take any value you want. Just make sure it's not too big, otherwise you won't be able to see it, it'll go off the screen. So, you know, keep it within below 200, I'd say. This will give the length of the pentagon sides, okay? And then remember, we keep this little turtle done here because it will keep it on the screen once you've done it. This turtle done, what will happen is it will pop up on the screen, so it'll pop up on your home page or wherever it pops up in on your computer, And until you cross that off, it won't do anything else within the remaining of the file. So you have to cross that off and then it will do everything else in the file. So that's just something worth remembering. You can just simply comment it out and do something like this, and then it will do the whole Python file. That's just something worth remembering. Same with plots as well. Okay, so that's question 5. That's how you draw a pentagon in Turtle. Question 6 was asking you to create a Pythagorean triple. Okay, so we use def because that's how we define a function. We've created our function and we've called it Pythagorean triple, perfect. And we've given it 3 arguments, A, B, and C, because what we want to do is test whether 3 values, A, B, and C, are a Pythagorean triple. Okay. Then we put the colon because we need that. Then we've said inside this function, we've said if A squared plus B squared is identically equal to C squared, then we'll return true, else we'll return false. Okay, so what this is doing is if you input 3 different values in here, it will test whether this is true, and this is what it means for 3 numbers to be a Pythagorean triple. That's just worth remembering as well. So similarly, you could put here return print these 3 values are a Pythagorean triple. Oh, spelled Pythagorean. Pythagorean triple. And you know, you could put here, we'll copy that, ooh, and we'll put it here and we'll say these 3 values are not a Pythagorean triple. Okay, but you know, we could have what we had before where we had true and false. Okay, and then what we can do is ask Python to print this function for given values. So if you were to print these values, that is a Pythagorean triple, so it will return true, and these are not, so it will return false. Perfect. Okay, the question 7 was spotting the error on the screen. So I've commented it out just for now because it will produce some errors. So what we're going to do is we're going to uncomment this. Okay, so notice we have some errors. So one thing to mention with this question is you could have easily put it into PyCharm and it would tell you exactly what is wrong. So if we hover over this here, perfect, there we go, it tells us it's expecting a colon. So we'll pop a colon in here and then we'll hover over this here and it says indent expected, perfect. Okay, and now there's no error, the Python file is fixed, there's no error. And this will work. So that is how you spot the error. Don't forget that if you have an error in your code or you're asked to spot the error, just put it into PyCharm and it will most likely tell you what is wrong. Okay, so finally moving on to question 8, this was plotting. So the first thing that is really important is making sure you import the relevant modules. So I asked you to do it in matplotlib. So in order to do that, we need to import this here. And this allows us to plot. Okay, perfect. Then we assign 2 lists here, and now we're going to plot them against each other. So this is how we plot, and we're plotting list 1, which is this one here, against list 2, which is this one here. We make the colour blue, we're going to have the line width as 1. The label, so this will be the legend at the top of the little key, will say align, and it will produce the colour and pattern of the plot, and it will say align. Now the line style is going to be dashed, so the line's going to go like this. The marker is going to be a square. The colour of that marker at each of these points is going to be purple, and that size is going to be 2. So that's how the graph's going to look. And then here we are plotting the x label as x-axis, the y label as y-axis, and we plot the title as Python plot of a line. Perfect. Then finally we plot the legend, which allows this label here to be produced at the top with the little key. And then finally we say plot show, and this will plot the Python plot. So those are the answers to this mini little quiz. I hope you enjoyed getting stuck in and doing a few extra little problems that you can do in Python. I did make them so that it was representative of what we've learned over this tutorial series. So that is the video. I really hope you enjoyed. The next video will be how you create a GitHub account. So GitHub is a place where you can store your code, you can upload your code, and also find code from other people as well and follow people. So that is the next video, and then I think that will be the final video in this series. Later in the future I may add some extra videos onto this series, but this is the finalizing video. There's nothing else to learn in Python. So you know, I want to say thank you again to everyone who has watched my videos, subscribed, liked. As I said, I've got huge plans for this channel. I have a Raspberry Pi on the way, so I'm gonna do some videos on Raspberry Pis. I'm gonna do some maths, physics series. I'm gonna look at NumPy. I've got so much planned, and I really hope that you will all stick with me throughout this channel's journey. And as I said, I really hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, then please like, subscribe and comment, and I'll see you all in the next video. And thank you again for sticking with me and following along with this tutorial series. I'll see you in the next video.